hope you all doing good. My name is Lucy Gichuki. If you're new here, karibu sana. Please consider subscribing and click on the notification bell so that anytime I upload a video, you'll be the first one to be notified. Leave a sweet comment down below. Let me get to know what you think. And on today's video, I wanna show you how to prepare simple meal, and that's chips masala. Chips masala is basically found in our hotels at a very high price. But imagine you can prepare it at the comfort of your own kitchen. And today, I wanna show you how to prepare it in a very simple way. And these are our ingredients of the day. We have our cumin, we have our paprika, we have our black pepper, we have our garlic. We only use our cloves of garlic. We have our onion, our salt, of course, to make it to taste, our green capsicum, our corianders, and of course, our potatoes. We'll first start by heating our oil. We're waiting for our oil to heat up. My eyes, oh my goodness. As you want, depending on the potatoes you have, or depending on the sauce you want to make. Check if my oil is ready. Our oil is ready, so we'll add in our potatoes. You must ensure that you are potatoes are dry up, they're not wet, so that you don't get the reaction when you put in your potatoes. I'll only do the few. So we'll wait for our potato to fry up as we continue to cut our ingredients. Corianders or danias. For me to get the, you know, to cut them in small size, I have to arrange them. So when cutting your corianders, ensure that you're cutting in small pieces. Or in small size. I don't know about the stem. Let me know in the comment section below. Is it good to use this in your your masalas or in anything that you're cooking and you're using your corianders. Because I saw someone, you know, saying that we don't use the stem, we only use the leaves. So I think we will start cooking our sauce, the masala sauce. Before our onion turn into golden brown, we add in our garlic. The reason as why I'm doing so is to ensure that my garlic has jangua. You know, when cooking your potatoes, don't keep on turning them. Zitavunjika, like you see, nimeshavunja hii moja. So don't keep on turning them. I've just turned them to ensure that zote zinapata mafuta vizuri. So we'll add in our spices. You know, I'm adding my spices here so that I can give my spices enough time to cook, because we need them to cook. First, I'll put in cumin, and you only do a teaspoon, not a tablespoon. Teaspoon ile kijiko kidogo. So I'll put in a teaspoon. That's cumin. And then put in black pepper. And the last thing I put in is Spanish paprika. Spanish paprika ukuna, it's a bit ikona chili. So I'll ensure unaeka kiasi ndio food is kwe kali. Tomato paste. You can do a tablespoon of tomato paste. It can depending on the quantity of potatoes that you're cooking. Then I'll add in my ketchup. For ketchup, I'll now add our chili. I'll only do half a teaspoon of chili. After adding all the ingredients, you can see that our sauce is thick. So I'll have to add in water. Be sure that you're adding in your water, not even a glass, just, a little bit. And then you let it to simmer. Remember to add in salt because you want it to have a taste. Then cover it to simmer. Guys, our sauce is ready and our fries is ready as well. So what we'll do here, we'll remove our fries from the oil and add in our sauce. As so. As you can see, our fries are dry up very well. Ensure that you've drained all the oil. Sorry. So we'll do this as we add here. Imagine, guys, it's as simple as this. I don't know how much you buy your masalas at your hotels, because the last time I bought a chips masala, it was actually costing 350, if I'm not wrong. But imagine it's as simple as you just seen. Everything only costs, I think, 200 shillings. Buying your potatoes and the ingredients, it's only... Okay, plus the spices, I think it's 500 shillings, but the spices you can use for a long time. Let me add the rest of the potatoes. So after adding your potatoes in our sauce, what we do is to mix them carefully. Remember they are fragile, so you should do it carefully, not to break them, but coat them carefully with the sauce. Hope you can see how it's turning. But imagine when your potatoes are dry enough, they won't break as you do this. They won't break. So ensure that your potatoes have dried very well. Now you heat. You can do this to any, you can do this at any time, even if your potatoes are not, they're not warm, because when mixing it with the masala, you will still warm them. And imagine guys, our potato, our chips masala is ready. So the final ketchup, what I'll do is to add our corianders on top. And remember, I don't have to cook our corianders. I only need the flavor to, no, I really need the flavor to our chips masala. That simple. So I'll serve it. Let me clean up the surface first. My kitchen working area is small. This is how the final looks. The final result is, as you can see guys. In case, if you ever come across your chips masala yellow in color, that means they added in turmeric. You can as well do turmeric, but for me, I only use paprika. Because I don't like the turmeric color. Not that it's bad, but I just don't like it being yellow. But if you like it that way, you can do it. You can add turmeric to your, you can include turmeric to your spices. You can also do turmeric at the same time do paprika. That is Spanish paprika. Oh my God. Honestly, it's sweet guys, you have to try this. If you have tried it, let me know in the comment section below. And if you try it in my own way, still comment down, let me know how it went for you, because honestly it's sweet. Imagine this goes only, and remember in the hotel they serve it, you know, in small quantity, and it's only 350 shillings. And you can do it at the comfort of your own kitchen. Why not try it? Why not cook it for your families? On to my next video. Bye. Bye-bye. Remember to subscribe and click on the notification bell. Till next time. Bye-bye.